This film is just sort of wall-to-wall action.
I've always been a big fan of chasing new technology and figuring out ways to create moments or experiences or shots that we haven't seen before.
I'm Ryan Gosling, and we're about to go behind the effects of The Gray Man. I've never made an action film on this scale, and what sort of blew me away was just the amount of people involved and just the amount of work that goes into this before I ever come on set.
It's probably the biggest scene for visual effects in the movie. It took all of a year and 9 months to do. All the interiors are practical replication of the C-130 interior built onto a rocker gimbal, so the whole thing does a little bit of rocking while we're in it. Joe and Anthony Russo really wanted to make the scene feel chaotic, so you know, we blew up one of the engines and then started ripping off the panels of the plane. So on our set gimbal, we took off all of the panels and then replaced them with just sort of a black duvetine, so that as the CG panels were coming off on set, we would rip a duvetine panel off and light would flood in the plane. And then we really rolled the camera around and we rolled the whole plane around to really feel like it was in deep, deep trouble.
We used a couple of techniques to execute that sequence, one of which was LED volume capture to capture Ryan's body, the body of the stunt players who were also going out of the plane with him.
And it's a cylindrical shape of LED panels with 160 cameras pointing inside the LED panels. It's probably 12 or 15 feet tall. And there's a treadmill built into the floor. And then we can play back the environment so that it lights Ryan. And what the 160 cameras does for us is make a photogrammetry per frame mesh of Ryan's entire body and his face.
Which basically photoreal captures Ryan's face and allows us to put that on a digidouble as he's falling through the air. So you're really seeing Ryan's face and Ryan's reactions and Ryan's emotions as if he were really falling through the air.
We started way, way early in pre-production for the trolley sequence doing storyboards. Then we did pre-viz. Then we did tech biz to help design what vehicles needed to be built.
You have an actual trolley that runs on tracks through Prague that we used. We had a bus rebuilt to look exactly like the trolley, but ran on tires for shots where we needed to move the tram at speeds that a tram couldn't achieve. We had a standing set of the tram built that can be shook so that it had vibration to it, but it was stationary and it had blue screen around it.
So all of the fighting that was done inside the trolley was done on a motion base in Prague. And pretty much all of the exterior trolley shots are enhanced with CGs, but all of the vehicles surrounding the trolley are all practical, stunt-driven, cars exploding, getting hit.
There's a camera we're using on this one called a pogo cam, which is basically a camera at the end of a long stick. And there's basically a boom operator is holding the stick. And then there's someone, you know, sitting there with a remote head that's operating the remote head on the camera. That was really unique. We used that quite a bit on the tram because it was very narrow and allows you to get to angles that you normally couldn't get to with a human operator. And it adds a really visceral dynamic quality.
What do you say we wrap this up? I mean, I'm having a blast, but it's way past the kids' bedtime.
There's a lot of gunfire, a lot of gunfighting, and it was at night, which makes for a tricky scenario with muzzle flashes in that you want it to interact with the people. Early on in pre-production, actually, I asked Steve Winden and his team. Steve Winden is our DP. They came up with this attachment that goes on the prop guns that's connected to the trigger of the prop guns. When you pull the trigger, it fires a little burst of light. When you're shooting a scene at night and you're shooting with guns that make big interactive flashes, the actors' faces should be brightly lit. Just a quick beat. So this LED device that Steve made was very handy for that. Claire and Six jump off a castle wall. That was accomplished with primarily stunts.
They were jumped on wires, so at the actual location, that moat that was around it was really only 2 or 3 feet deep. And we have a decelerator when somebody leaps and we need to save them, we decelerate it. We built a replica of the same height on our stage and had cameras down in the water to get a leap of the same height into the tank without the safety cables.
They found some kind of inflatable pool somewhere nearby and we hopped in and hopped out. So they made us look pretty cool again, but it, you know, the lion's share of that was done by much more talented people. Make sure to check out The Gray Man only on Netflix.